What is break-even analysis? What is the implications on business decisions?
Welcome to Practical Business Analysis. My name is Américo Cunha. Learn fast, solve problems, make good decisions. Let's start.
The three most important applications of break-even analysis on business decisions are 1. The term, the quantity of sold units at which the cost equal revenues. 2. Find the quantity demanded at which the buying costs equal the internal production costs. 3. Compare business processes. And the term, the lowest cost for requested quantity range. Let's get started on the first application. During a business plan, it is important to find out the sales quantity that cover the costs. Any company has fixed costs and variable costs. Fixed costs are constant, whatever quantity of goods or services produced. For instance, salary must be paid independently of units produced and therefore are considered fixed costs. Other fixed costs are property taxes, leasing payments, and depreciation. Variable costs include direct costs to produce each unit, each item. The most common variable costs are raw material and components. Variable costs increase with the quantity produced. Visually, we can draw a graph that relates cost and quantity. You can see that the fixed costs are constant, regardless of the quantity produced. On the other hand, variable costs increase with the quantity produced. The red line represents the total cost, that is, the fixed cost plus the direct variable cost per unit produced. The cost profile has to be compared to revenues. In this graph, you can see the revenue. The revenue is represented by the blue line. The revenue increases with the units sold. We can have a good visualization of the break-even analysis when cost and revenue lines are represented in the same graph. When the total cost is higher than the revenue, the red line is above the blue line. It means that the company is losing money. On the other hand, when the blue line, revenue, is above the red line, total cost, the company has profit. The quantity at the intersection between the two lines is called break-even quantity. Below this quantity, the company is losing money, and above it, the company is making a profit. The break-even quantity is determined by dividing the fixed costs by the difference between unit sale price minus unit variable costs. A second very common application of the break-even analysis is to support the buy or make decision. The decision of buying supply items externally or produce them internally. There are several business factors that should be taken into account, such as strategic vision, time to market, tools available, knowledge, skills, and the last but not least, cost analysis, in which break-even analysis can be used. In the graph, we have the buy alternative represented in green and the make alternative in purple. The fixed cost for the buy alternative is almost zero. Therefore, the total cost depends on the quantity purchased times the unit price. The make alternative is different. It has a fixed cost to deploy the infrastructure to produce the product or to provide a service. It is important to realize that here we are looking for an alternative with the lowest cost. We can see that below the break-even quantity, QB, The Green Line, by alternative, has a lower cost. Above QB, the Purple Line, make alternative, has the lower cost. The break-even quantity can be determined by dividing the fixed cost by the difference between buying unit cost minus making unit cost. The math is the same of the first example, although the conclusion is different. The third application of the break-even analysis is to select a process alternative based on the quantity demanded. To facilitate the understanding, let's suppose three types of production process. The first, a manual process. The second, semi-automated process. And the third, an entirely automated production process. The manual process has the lowest fixed cost and highest variable unit cost. On the other extreme, we have the fully automated solution that has the highest cost to be deployed, but can deliver the lowest unit production cost. We can compare the three alternatives visually by plotting each total cost per quantity produced. We can see that each alternative has the lowest cost depending on the quantity produced. Lower quantities make the manual production process very attractive cost-wise. What can be seen in the blue area of the graph? Below the break-even quantity QB1, the manual process has the lowest total cost. The same automated alternative is very competitive when the demand is between quantities QB1 and QB2. Above the break-even quantity QB2, the fully automated alternative has the best cost performance. The math is the same used before, but now should be done considering two alternatives each time. To conclude, in this video, we saw three applications of the break-even analysis. 1. Cost versus revenue. 2. Buy or make decision. And 3. Process selection. Now, I think you can answer three questions. What is break-even analysis? What are the three most common applications? How to apply break-even analysis to support business decisions? You can send your questions in the comment area below. I'll be very pleased to answer them. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next lesson.